Bonjour, je m'appelle Dr. Tin et bienvenue à French 1311, chapitre 4, leçon 2. Aujourd'hui, nous allons étudier le vocabulaire de la famille. Le vocabulaire de la famille. Hello, my name is Dr. Tin and welcome to French 1311, Chapter 4, Lesson 2. Today we are going to study the vocabulary of the family. We are going to study the vocabulary of family. Ça va? Très bien. Page 100. 4, page 108. La famille. Family. Family. Okay. Les grands-parents. Répétez. Les grands-parents. Les grands-parents. Grandparents. Très bien. Le grand-père. Le grand-père, le grand-père. La grand-mère, la grand-mère. Know that there is no E at the end of grand, right? With grand-mère, there's no E. Okay. La grand-mère, le grand-père. Okay. Les parents, parents. Okay, it can also mean relatives. Okay, les parents, le père, la mère, les enfants, children, le fils, the S is pronounced, le fils, okay, la fille. La fille, le fils means the son or son, right? La fille means the girl, right? It can mean girl or daughter. So la fille, daughter or girl. La fille, le fils. Son, S-O-N. Le frère, brother, sister, la sœur, ok? Le cousin, male, cousin, la cousine, ok? Female, cousin. Le neveu, nephew, très bien. La nièce, niece, right? Les petits-enfants, petit, here means grand, G-R-A-N-D, grandchildren, okay? Here we say les grands-parents, grand. Parents, grandparents, you don't use grand with children, you use petit. Ok, les petits-enfants, grandchildren. Le petit-fils, la petite fille, ok, granddaughter, le petit-fils. La petite fille, les petits-enfants, grandchildren. Ok, le beau-père means stepfather. La belle-mère, stepmother. It can also mean le beau-père can also mean father-in-law. Then la belle-mère can also mean mother-in-law. So, stepfather our father-in-law for le beau-père, right? La belle-mère, stepmother or mother-in-law. Okay, le beau-fils, le beau-fils, le beau-fils can mean step-son, right? Or son-in-law, son-in-law. La belle, la belle, pardon, la belle fille, la belle fille, la belle fille can be stepdaughter or daughter-in-law. So le beau-fils, right? Stepson or son-in-law. La belle fille, la belle fille, stepdaughter or daughter-in-law. Très bien. Le beau-frère, le beau-frère, le beau-frère. OK, le beau-frère, brother-in-law, OK. La belle sœur, la belle sœur, sister-in-law, OK. Le demi-frère, half-brother, la demi-sœur, half-sister. OK, to say, either, right, brother, okay, or older brother, you use the adjective, aîné, the masculine form, all right, and then you add the E, aîné with an E, for the feminine form, okay, to say younger, you use the adjective cadet, for the masculine, and then you would say cadette for the feminine. So to say elder brother, you will say le frère aîné, elder sister, all right, or older sister, you say la sœur aînée, the same sound, but with the feminine, la sœur, you add an E. Okay, let's go back to now. Le demi-frère is half-brother. La demi-sœur is half-sister. Okay, très bien. Le frère aîné, très bien. Older brother, la sœur aînée, older sister. Le frère cadet, le frère cadet, le frère cadet. Okay. Younger brother. La sœur cadette, la sœur cadette, OK? Older sister, OK. We got some adjectives to describe your situation. Are you single? Is your mother dead? Is your father alive, right? Is your father divorced? All right. Is your mother divorced? Right. Are you engaged? Are you married? Are you living in a civil union that is registered but not in a traditional marriage? We've got the adjectives here. All right. Célibataire. So here, use the verb être. You conjugate être, you know, you can say I am single. You just do the verb être in the present tense. You will say je suis, and then you add the adjective. The adjective has an E for the masculine, so it is good for both masculine singular and feminine singular. So a woman can say je suis célibataire, the same thing. Right, and then a man can say, je suis célibataire. Même chose, the same thing. Okay, décider, répétez, décider, décider sounds like deceased, right? Décédé, décédé, décédé. Right, you add an E if you are using it with a female, right? The same thing with divorcer, divorcer, divorcer. You add an E if It's a woman that is talking, a woman you are talking about. Okay. Fiancé, fiancé, engaged, right? You add an E to fiancé if you're talking about a woman. If it's a woman talking. Marié, 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 married. It has just one R in French. 2 R's in English, right? 1 R in French. Marié, marié, marié. You add an E if you are talking about a woman. Ça va? Très bien. Now, this last adjective, pacsé, 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 is used to describe people in a union that is not a traditional marriage. They have registered their union, right, at the courthouse that they are living together, right? So if it is that union, not a traditional marriage, they have a civil union, right, registered with either a man or a woman living together, or two women living together, or two men living together. You can say pacsé, pacsé, pacsé. You add an E if it's a woman you're talking about. Ça va? Okay, to say I am the only son, right? Only, the adjective to use is unique, 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 only. Okay. So you can say je suis fils unique. Je suis fils unique. Je suis fils unique. I am the only son. Je suis fille unique. Je suis fille unique. I am the only daughter. All right, to say husband in French is le mari, to say wife in French is la femme, la femme, la femme. You know, la femme can also mean woman, right? So the same word is used for wife, right? La femme, wife. And then when you come here, c'est la fille, right? Can also mean girl or daughter. So la fille, daughter, right, or girl. La femme, woman, or wife. Ça va? Très bien. Au revoir et à bientôt.